In the previous video, you were introduced to the general working practices of the timeline effects. Let's start going through each timeline effects in a little more detail, starting off with resize. Smoke is resolution independent, which means that any of your sequences can be any resolution you choose. You can mix resolution and frame rates in the same sequence, but all segments eventually conform to the sequence settings. Smoke uses the resize timeline effects to do this. If a source clip differs from the sequence by its physical frame size, bit depth, or frame interpretation, Smoke will apply a resize timeline effects to the relevant segments. For example, this sequence has a resolution of 1920 by 1080. In the media library, there is a source clip that is 3K by 2K. I'll select the clip to load it into the source viewer and mark the clip with an in and out marker. I'll select the gap in the sequence and also mark it up. Pressing the overwrite button edits the clip into the sequence, and you'll see straight away that the new segment has a line indicator across the top of the segment. Selecting the segment shows a resize timeline effects in the effects pipeline, and the basic parameters are available for quick tweaking in the toolbar. Let's go into the effects editor and tweak the resize settings further. In the resize editor, the viewing area is split into two viewers. On the left is the original clip, and on the right is the result. Notice that the destination resolution controls are grayed out, but are set to the resolution of the sequence. However, when performing compositing operations, you will have access to the original media and its full resolution. Normally, if you're scaling images of different sizes and aspect ratios, the settings you need to be concerned with is the type of resize and the image filtering. Let's start off with the resize types. You have four resize types or modes that you can use to adjust your image. The first mode to look at is center crop. This simply places an image in the center of the resize and is cropped if the image is larger than the resized frame. There is no scaling being applied to the original image. The second mode is letterbox. This mode will scale the longest edge of the original image to the resized frame. This is quite common if you had to place a 16:9 image in a 4:3 frame. The result image will be letterboxed top and bottom. The third mode is fill. This mode will take the original image and stretch it in all directions until every pixel is completely filled into the result frame. The fourth and final mode is crop edges. This mode works in combination with the bounding box seen in the original image viewer. You can use this bounding box to isolate specific portions of your image or to perform a basic pan and scan movement. The image filtering is the quality of how Smoke scales the image. Lankos is regarded as best quality, and Impulse is regarded as draft or preview quality. Let's scale this large image to fit the result frame. I also want to specifically isolate a section of the image. You can zoom the viewer if necessary, and set the resize mode to crop edges. Using the bounding box, you can quickly lock down the section you are after. As you have seen, all the settings are editable and most can be animated for added effect, although we won't create any animation in this lesson. When you exit the editor, the result is already in the sequence, and depending on your hardware, you might be able to preview it during playback. Once you are satisfied with the result, select the segment and press the render button. When the render is complete, you can review the result. Remember, you can always modify your settings as you continue to work on your edit. In the next video, you start having a look at title creation.